in the present time. So there is another approach, interventionism. Microfinance is a part of the framework of interventionism as it is defined as the need for intentional development along capitalism in order to ameliorate the disorder faults of pockets, Thomas in his book mentioned. So, however, interventionism looks to combine state and market forces. It is good that this coins that microfinance is a part of framework interventionism, need for intentional development, but the interventionism looks, the approach combine the state and the market forces, the public and private joined together. So moreover, microfinance is an intentional attempt at development using the capitalist methodology. So you see, good that it is working for the poor people, but the problem is it is also using the capitalist methodology, the capitalism reach at the doorstep of the poor people. However, the good thing is through borrowing small amounts of money, Grameen borrowers and other microfinance borrowers become entrepreneurs and owner operators of small enterprises that conduct business independently in their own communities, in their local areas. In this way, they increase their family income and savings and educate their children and buy healthcare facilities from the market and plan for their futures. Microfinance institutions help to mentor business within the local market by providing a support to the local community and teaching basic business management skills. Microfinance schemes are targeted at those people who are normally excluded from mainstream banking services, training programs and business development advices. These microfinance agencies goal for each person they can help to develop his or her self-sufficiency and self-confidence. It is good. However, here the question is raised, when an individual gains these important qualities, then he or she can pull out of the depth of poverty for his or her good. So is it possible individually? So now I'm going to talk mean test methods in Canada. It is used here to address the poverty. Mean tests used in Canada to evaluate the assets and income of the welfare recipients. Means test eligibility is based on applications of income and assets, but it virtually ignores individuals and families' personal needs. It ignores applicants' living arrangement, housing condition and standards of living. It is a proof that poor law attitudes influenced by Canadian political leaders in the 1920s, and credit unions in Canada are local solutions to mobilize the poor and facilitate networking among them. So they are working at locally for local economic solutions that promotes local small businesses and work to meet local people banking needs. So now I'm coming to talk about the world famous report, World Development Report, Sustainable Development. Reducing poverty is the fundamental objectives of economic development, a World Development Report. However, safe and sustainable environmental policy programs and projects are also vital for poverty eradication and human development. Several NGOs and many international organizations are attempting to address poverty through the different schemes in different way. However, these NGOs, INGOs, are working in piecemeal and often cancel out each other's efforts, and they do not have coordination, communication each other. They are working in the silo. Hence, environmental sustainable holistic development approach is essential for local poverty eradication. For poor women, their poverty is not just an issue of nutrition, basic needs, fulfill basic needs. It needs to address, establish their justice, voice, choice, and fundamental human right needs. Environmental sustainable holistic development is an inclusive poverty definition and an integrated program for income development, education, health, and legal services for poor women at village level are urgently needed. So therefore, a globally unified poverty definition and uniform global poverty reduction strategy may be not appropriate at all level pockets in the world. Because the depth of poverty and causes of poverty differ from society to society, state to state, region to region. Therefore, it needs to identify poverty headcounts of both absolute and relative poverty. Barbara Slater, she suggests this thing. So at the same time, public policy should be reviewed and updated, and poverty-related trends and conditions must be monitored. So that you design and develop program, but you should be monitored, take the feedback, see the feedback, what is going on, and then you continuously improve the program on the basis of the feedback. This total development approach plays a crucial role in giving people the ability to develop their potential both economically and socially. So this report actually talks sustainable development approach prepared by Bertrand Commission report. So this report mentioned to reduce poverty and to promote Bertrand Commission sustainable development, human need centered 9 conditions could be considered for local poverty eradication. So the 9 elements are justice, sustainability, inclusiveness, gender equality, good literacy, human security, and reduce human security and citizenship development. State should regulate, deregulate. The suggestions, some recommendations are, state should deregulate free trade within their country to protect its local products and businesses from imported competition. So this is one. Explores underdeveloped countries and to need to work on a sustainable development agenda, because give the project money for 3 years and then discontinue the project, and that the people, those the project beneficiaries are in a problem. They cannot continue their activities of economic activities, social activities, and other things. So therefore, it needs under developing country to continue for the projects, activities for the sustainable development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generation to meet local people's own need. So that is the Bertrand report, give more emphasis, and it is now called the sustainable development approach by instead of economic, only focusing on economic development to address the poverty. So now I'm going to talk about, I'm at the end of my conclusion. So neither economic, so throughout the whole discussion and debates and the different approaches, parameters of addressing the poverty, we find that the paper finds that neither economic nor social viewpoint are enough to address poverty. So rather, a combination of the two is needed. Most meaningful solutions to poverty work are at the local level, we find it, and different debates, different argument, practical argument, praxis mentioned that one. Even international aid investments, which is delivered globally, must eventually be administered locally. Grameen Bank is a very good example of an integrative approach to deal with local poor economic need and develop networking among them. GB extends its collateral free, I give one example, the Grameen Bank extends its collateral free banking services, which caters primarily to rural women in Bangladesh and mobilizes the poor women in the villages. So Grameen Bank model is a self-sustaining process and makes its members work both individually and collectively to move up their social economic tiers. So Grameen Bank provides 16.7 million loans to 8.6 million rural landless people in Bangladesh. Grameen Bank narrows down its poverty measurement to the borrower's level. So it uses 10 indicators to measure poverty for its members. So appendix one, the next slide, the indicators are there. So Grameen Bank approach is a combination of social and economic holistic development model that drives the Bangladeshi rural poor towards self-employment and independence and to empower themselves. They are encouraged to make decisions on behalf of the families, plan and save for the future for their children, and alleviate the burden of poverty from their life and from their children, for the family members. So therefore, Grameen Statistics 2006 states that 58% of the borrowers have successfully graduated from poverty through the use of Grameen loans. So this is the poverty measures indicators. So I'm not going to discuss because it is time consuming, but I can say Grameen Bank said those who have $380 from rich in house annual income, those who have, they have the house, which house value is $3,800, could be one of the indicator that she is a little bit out of acute poverty. And family members drink pure drinking water or arsenic free tubers, boiled water or purified water. All children in the family over 6 years age are going to school or finish primary school. And minimum weekly loan disbursement of loan borrowers is $200, able to repay the loan. And family use family sanitary latrine. Family members have adequate clothing for everyday use. So these are the indicators. And lastly, last indicator that family can take care of its health. If any members of the family falls ill, the family can afford to take all necessary steps to seek adequate health care measures for the family members. So in conclusion, I would like to say that a key part of Grameen Bank strategy is to bringing women together on a weekly basis, not only to pay their loans, but also to share experiences, support one another's business, and to hear from the bank staff about how to keep their family healthy and prepare for natural disaster. Grameen Bank is an example that demonstrates the concept of microfinance is rooted in local conditions and its activities address local poverty solutions. The loans are small and given to individuals who are rooted in the village, local villages. These borrowers use the loans to create small businesses which serve to local population. From the above discussion argument, I can draw a conclusion that poverty is depriving poor people of access to resources to achieve fulfilling their basic needs. Capitalism and globalization of the free market economy makes poverty global and impoverishing the underdeveloping countries. So poverty, injustice, and inequality are worst in capitalism that we find everywhere in the magazine, television, radio, lecture, in the university discussion, seminar, everywhere that poverty, injustice, inequality are created, and it is worst in capitalism. It is advantageous only to certain group of people, so to wealthy nations. Over 50 countries are now poorer than they were 10 years before. See? And more other countries are going down too. So therefore, Barbara Slater suggests for an approach to address poverty which should be considered that closely analyzes its local causes and implications to address issues of poverty. Therefore, it is important to identify poverty issues locally, find resources, alternative paths, tools, programs, services that are suitable to marginalized people in their local context. Paths are adaptable to marginalized people to uplift them from the sufferings of poverty and injustice and misery. Therefore, the paper emphasizes that while poverty is a global problem resulting from global issues, its solution can only be found locally, and therefore the nature of poverty must be defined locally. So this is a big paper discussion, and I tried my best to make this paper with evidence that although poverty could be a global problem, but its solutions and defense must be in the local context, local situation. Otherwise, any program, theories, definitions, solutions will not work to solve the poverty at the local level. So thank you very much to all of you to hear this lengthy paper. So if you have any comments and questions, please feel free to ask me now or afterward the session, and you can also ask question or any suggestions you like to give a comments. I have also one blog, you can write to your opinion there, or you can email to me. My email address is kazi@hotmail.com. Thank you for attending the seminar of my